Junior developers often ask me what is the number one thing that they can do to improve their software, and my answer is almost always the same: test-driven development. Hi, my name is Juani Bryson. Today I'm sharing with you what I think is my software superpower, writing TDD. If you've never written TDD before, I don't think that it's an overstatement to say that this is the most valuable tutorial that I can give you. First, we're going to discuss the general concepts behind test-driven development. Then we're going to set up a problem to test drive. And then finally, we're going to spend the majority of this video actually doing test-driven development. The two rules of TDD are write a failing automated test before writing any code and eliminate duplication. These rules sound simple, but they have some wide-reaching consequences. The first rule, write a failing automated test before writing any code, implies that when we add any new features, we need to make sure we already have a test in place for that feature. The second rule, eliminate duplication, allows us to switch gears between writing code that works and writing code that is maintainable. TDD is often followed in three steps: red, green, refactor. In red, we want to write a minimal test that fails, and we count not compiling as failing. In green, we want that test to pass with as little effort as possible. This allows us to write some pretty dirty code in this step. And finally, in the refactor step, we're going to clean up any duplication caused by the green step. When this process is followed correctly, you should find that you get pretty fast feedback on the correctness of your code. So the next question is, what example are we going to use to demonstrate test-driven development? I like the idea of writing a package that can compute the magnitude of a two-dimensional vector. So let's jump into the terminal and I'll call go mod init to create a package tutorial slash vec2. At this stage, it might be tempting to create your vector2 struct, but that's not what we're doing here. We're in the red stage of TDD, and in the red stage, we're going to start by writing a test. So let's create a test file called vec2_test.go, and in here we'll give it the package name vec2. And given that we're in the red phase, we want to create a test that fails, but remembering that not compiling also counts as failing. So let's create ourselves a test function. I'll call this test vec2 magnitude, and it will take the argument t of type testing t. And inside here, I'm going to call v is equal to new, and I'll pass in the values 4 and 0. And then I'm going to go if v.magnitude does not equal 4, then I'm going to call t.fail. And we'll save that. And now if we jump into the terminal and we call go test, then the test fails because new is undefined. So the red step is complete, we have a test that fails. Moving on to the green step, we want to make the test pass as quickly as possible. So I'm going to create a new file called vec2.go, and in here we'll give it the package name vec2. And next I'm going to define a type vec2 struct. And I'm going to keep it empty for now, and the reason for that is that I'm just trying to get this test to pass. And next we're going to define our new function, and new will take two arguments x and y, which will both be type float64, and will return a pointer to a vec2. Inside I'm just going to return the empty vec2 pointer, and then I want to define the magnitude method for vec2. So we'll do this by using vec2 as the receiver, and we'll call the function magnitude, and it will return a float64. Now, because all I want to do is make this test pass, I'm just going to return the expected value, which is 4. And if we save this and jump into the terminal and run go test here, now our test passes. So the green step is complete, but the code is looking pretty dirty, especially with that return of 4 from magnitude and the empty vec2 struct that we have. So now we're going to move on to the next step, which is removing duplication. The value 4 appears both in our test here and in our vec2 return value. So let's fix that. The first thing that I'm going to do is jump into here, and I'm going to add a field called x, which will be of type float64. And then down in our new function, I'm going to set x equal to the input x. And then finally, in our magnitude function, I'm just going to return v.x. If we save this, jump back into the terminal and run go test, Our test still passes, but the duplication has now been removed. Now, some of you may be thinking, hey, this magnitude function still isn't correct. And that's absolutely true. However, it is correct as far as our tests are concerned. So if we want to make the magnitude function correct as far as our expectations of that function is concerned, it's time to go back to the test and back to our red step where we're going to write a failing test. If we jump back into the code and jump into the vec2test.go, I'm just going to copy and paste this test here, and I'm going to change this to both axes, and I'm going to change the input value of y to -3, and then under v.magnitude I now expect that to be 5. So if we save this, then we jump back into the terminal and we call go test, this test fails. So we're once again at the end of the red step. We have written a minimal test that fails. Moving on to the green step, let's make this test pass as fast as possible. The easiest way I can think of doing this is jumping into the magnitude function and saying if v.y does not equal 0, then we're just going to return 5, and otherwise we're going to return v.x, and of course we need to actually capture the y value. So let's add this to the vec2 struct here, and let's add this into our new function with y is equal to the input y. If we save this, jump back into the terminal, and run go test. Now our test passes again. Now we're at the end of the green step. Now I know that weird hacky if statement in the magnitude function looks pretty horrible, and it is horrible. I feel bad even having done it, but the next step is to refactor and remove duplication. So obviously this 5 here is some form of duplication, so we want to get rid of it. And to be fair, the simplest way to solve this problem at this stage is to actually just solve the magnitude function correctly. So let's go with math.squareRoot and go v.x times v.x plus v.y times v.y. And if we delete this if statement and save and jump back into the terminal and call go test, everything passes. We've now gone through the red-green refactor loop twice, and hopefully that's ingrained the process of test-driven development for you. TDD requires a bit of patience and practice at first, but is an invaluable technique for disciplined software development. I've been Juani Bryson, happy testing, and I'll see you later.